everybody doing, Rhode Island? How are you? My name's Anthony. It's good to see you. I've been looking forward to this show all day because I've been looking forward to it longer than that, since I heard about it. Since I heard I was gonna do it. But I played a show earlier today. This is my second show today. And my first show, I opened for a band called Bare Naked Ladies in Massachusetts at a weird campgrounds thing. It was weird. It was so weird. And there was nobody. Everybody was either under 12 or over 60. There was nobody in between the ages of 12 and 60. There. So it was weird. So I was standing on stage and I'm playing and everybody's just talking over it and getting like drunk during the day, which is embarrassing for them. Waiting for the Bare Naked Ladies to come on, and I'm just thinking like, man, thank God I'm playing another show tonight where people are back really excited to see me play. Thank you. So if you haven't seen me play solo before, basically the deal is I sit at home and I watch TV all the time when I'm not on tour with the band. And I get bored of that and I decide I want to come out and play some songs for people, and some songs are songs that I wrote, some are Bayside songs, some are not Bayside songs. So this first song, I was watching Mallrats the other day, and this song came on, and this song is it's in the credits, and I was like, oh, that's a great song, I'm going to play that one. It's called Suzanne. Suzanne, you're all that I wanted. Oh. little more guitar. I know we did this. We went over this like 2 hours ago, and now I'm changing my mind. I hate to make you look bad. I want everybody to know that it's my fault. All right, sing this one. All
right.
All right.
And all the sorrow.
grow in this world. Let me take it to the hurting ground. Where all good men are trampled down. Just to settle a bet that cannot be won. Between a prideful father and his son.
Are you Alex?
I am.
All right, so you got in okay?
Yeah.
All right, cool, because I just handed in the guest list like 10 minutes ago. I
paid, but it's right. Cool.
Oh, sorry, man.
No worries.
The word. Singers should not be in charge of anything. Does anybody have our new record, Killing Time? Anybody? Yeah! Cool, so when that came out and I was doing these acoustic things, I was thinking about what songs on the new record might make sense to do acoustic, and so I was going through them and trying to work out songs, and of course I picked the two heaviest songs on the record that I thought would never work acoustic, and those are the ones I spent the most amount of time trying to make work. And I think they do. This song's called Already Gone.
Thanks to me, I was wrong for coming here. You'll wake up.
So, did you know the one from that record? It's a new joke, I didn't tell it to you. So I have a MySpace page, myspace.com/AnthonyRanieri. There's a funny story about this song. This song is on that page. I was thinking about maybe putting out a solo record next year. If that happens, I haven't told my label that I was going to do that yet, but I think when Alex posts this video, they'll know my intentions. When I do that, this song will be on there. It's called The Ballad of Bill the Saint. And the funny story, I'm going to tell this story because it's a good one, how closely connected to NSYNC this song is. I was playing a show in Orlando, Florida, and Chris Kirkpatrick came to the show from NSYNC. And he came backstage and he said hello and we got to talking and we sort of became friends and he invited me back to his house, which is fucking the size of this block. And he has a big studio in the basement, and we were just hanging out in the studio and I was listening to some stuff, NSYNC demos special. So we were listening to stuff, and he was like, "Hey, if you want to record something, let's mess around." So the version of this song that's on my MySpace page, I recorded in Chris Kirkpatrick's basement. True story. And I just heard that Justin Timberlake bought part of MySpace recently. So this song, I mean, if it wasn't for NSYNC, then you wouldn't know the song. You really probably still don't. I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. It's called The Ballad of Bill the Saint. One was enough to get him this far, and two would just complicate things. And he says you'll be sitting pretty in a dark room in the city, 'cause one doesn't leave room for you and me. Sitting on my couch watching TV a couple of days ago, and I was noodling around on the guitar, and I kind of was messing with this song, and I sort of learned it. So I figured I'd go with it and see if, see how far confidence got me, and it worked out. I'm gonna play it again. It's called "Still Can't Say Goodbye."
I get crazy. I'm talking.
my pride, lost my mind. I'm torn. So no telling what tomorrow holds. And who let this feeling die when all I did was try? Some say it's all fate, but I say we control our lives and it by destiny. She outbests me, that's fine. Now make-believe thriller, apathetical, insisting me fairly equally. The truth is doubts, raw that got to call mine. There's no telling what tomorrow.
So we're doing a really cool tour. The band, Bayside, the band. We're doing a really cool tour in the fall with Saves the Day, a band called Saves the Day, and I'm the Avalanche. And we're not coming to Rhode Island, so. Sorry. We're going to Boston, though. Yeah. We're going to Boston, right? How far is that?
An hour.
An hour? Oh, I expect to see all of you in Boston. Yeah.
You will.
Live there.
Show. I want to thank all those guys very much. This song's for them. It's called The Ghost of St. Valentine.
When I thought it.
do that. I'm gonna play another
Bayside song. Younger, I used to write very angry songs, which you guys know, because if you guys come to the shows and you sing all the angry songs. But I got older and wiser. Not really wiser, just older. Older and too tired to be angry. Angry, at least not all the time. But I started seeing that there's two sides to every situation, and I wrote this song, had a big breakup, the big breakup a couple years ago when I was writing this record, and I wrote some angry songs first, and then I wrote this song, because I was like, you know, you gotta see things from both perspectives, look at it fairly, and then I did, and then I went back to angry songs, because I figured out that I was right. But I gave it, you gotta give it a shot first.
So I sit here, writing words in our old place. They all come out as letters, and I contemplate mistakes that we all make. The start and the ending of errors.
Smile.
Against the wall.
somehow, again, I was watching TV. It all comes from TV. I love Law and Order, but I didn't get this one from Law and Order. This one's not about Law and Order. So, 4-2. Sorry, I'm trying to talk to you and watch the same. So I was watching TV and this movie came on with Mandy Moore in it, who is one of my favorites. Who I love a lot, and she sings a song in the movie that I love very much, and I decided I wanted to play it. So here it is. Said, I did my solo dance recital today. There's a song that's inside my soul. There's a song that I try to write over and over. I pray to be only yours. So I was like messing around with that one. I was trying to figure it out. And my girlfriend, I was playing it. I was like in my little studio thing. And my girlfriend came in and she said, "You know that song's about God, right?" But I said, "Is it really?" And she was like, "Yeah, did you even pay attention to the movie at all?" I said, "No, but Mandy Moore looked really good when she was saying it." So. I got one more left. Thank you guys very much, Providence. Woo! I'll be over at the merch table. Come say hello. This song's called Megan. Oh, one more story. This song, do you guys know that this is not a Bayside song? Is everybody knows? We put this song on our acoustic record, and most people didn't know that it was a Smoking Pope song. And now, when we see the Smoking Pope guys, they always thank us for letting them play our song. It's true, and I got a bunch of people that like Twittered at me and said that they went to go see Alkaline Trio, and this band that opened for them covered a Bayside song. And it was the Smoking Pope playing their own song. Well, here it is. It's called Megan.